This is a shir on Lekutei Sichas Chiluk Yud Gimel, Parshas Nasi Sicha Aleph. It's on page 16. Sif Aleph. Kibedubir kamim poamim. Haklal shateri hi nitzchis betokfu benegil lechol ateri kula. It's not only pshat, ateri hi nitzchis, coming to b'sheilu, those who think that certain mitzvahs are, we have to change it, lefi the ruach of the time, etc. So we say, no, ateri hi nitzchis. It's more than that. Teira Nitzchus means that even those in Yanu, which are Piteira, we don't have them now. Like mitzvahs later in the Bisa Mikdash, etc. Since not Piteira, we don't have those mitzvahs now. Nevertheless, even Lagabi them, the Teichana Inyan is Inyan Nitzchi. His Gam and Yanu Mashabiteira, Shabagashmis Einam Bismanenum. Such in Yanu, which are in Teira, which are Begashmis, we don't have them now. Like stories that you have in the Teira. Mitzvahs that don't apply now. Nimtzoyim him gamachsha beruchni yusa. Upon the beruchni is, we still have that in. Since there's a certain heiron, avidis adam, a certain ruchni stikini that's still around now. Kabiz meisavari, a ruchni is, imakir v'sheirish agashmis. Ruchni is the makir v'sheirish agashmis. L'chura, the isaf over here is negeya, to say. It's not just that Rabbi's meisav, the rechagav, the ruchni is the sheirish agashmis. T'chwana say, the teir is nitzchis. If we say that Moshe, a mitzvah of Aved in the Beis HaMikdash. Mitzvah in Aved in the Beis HaMikdash, we don't have that now, the mitzvah of Begashmis. Elamai, we have it, Aved in Beruchnis. So, in Pashtus, you learn that what's the pshat that we have the Inyi Beruchnis? The Iker is the mitzvah of Begashmis. The Inyi Beruchnis that you could learn, it's also a pchin of the mitzvah. It's not the etzim of mitzvah alone. Or if you have a story that the Torah tells you the way it happened, Begashmis. Right now, we don't have that inyan. It's a story. We have an inyan that we can learn out. It's a teichin, something, aruch nistigim, which is daimed to it. But the ikra alim, we don't have now. Ebaze, well, this is gekumen, that the Torah, it's not shy to say, lamit in ganzen with the whole emes, that Torah is nitzchis. It's not nitzchis in even mushla. Because we don't have the ikra of the Torah now. At least this chalokim of Torah. We have only a pchina, a remez, a inyan ruchni, but the inyan alayim felt yet. We don't have it now. Meil the Rebbe's meisiv, the pun fakert. Like the famous scene that teira medaber is bel yeinu v'remezes v'tachteinim. Every single inyan in teira, this is the way it is l'maylo. This is the way it is in ruchnis and yon, neil mesel yeinim, in pchinas ruchnis, and avedis adam beruchnis. For them, we're at nishtalshul, that we have that inyan in Gashmis also, that there was a meisiv b'gashmis, that they went through the midbar, or a meisiv, whatever story it says in the Torah, or mitzvahs, they have to mekayim in Eifan Gashmi. The inyan is always the beruchnis. The inyan is the beruchnis, that's the shayri shayri. For them, that the shtalshul inyan b'gashmi. So, meila, if we have now, the ruchnis, the kecheilu, kom techezes, the ikir is still here, so the Torah is nitzchis. Chol ha-shleim, says this. Okay. Chayim b'inyan, nevim pasha seino, minyan b'nei gershon b'nei mirari. Beginning of Parshat Nase, we discuss the minyan, the counting of B'nei Gershon and B'nei Merari. That's Chalase and Nemeres B'Seif Parshat Kidemes, which is minyan B'nei Ka'as, Hamistayim B'Parshat Seinu. Also, the beginning of the counting of the Levim that carried the Mishkan, which starts in the end of Parshat B'Midbar, where we counted Ka'as. So all these are three inyanim, minyan of B'nei Gershon, Merari, Ka'as, Sha'afshah B'Gash M'Yusan, Einan Inyan Nitzchi, we don't have, it's not Inyan Nitzchi. They don't count one time, they were counted. It's not Inyan Nitzchi. Shetzivu l'mneisim v'minyan atzmi rak pamachas b'shona ha'sheni s'oseisim eretz Mitzrayim. It happened only once in the second year after he left Mitzrayim. It's Inyan beruch niusi v'nitzchi b'chol day v'day. But the ruch niusi inyan is always Nitzchi. You have it every single generation. This Aveda or this Matzah, this Inyan beruch niusi that b'nei Gershon, b'nei Ka'as, and b'nei Merari are being counted. Humans are back to him. A different shayl. Lama hutzcha Yisrael Yisrael b'midbar abayim shana. Why did Eden have to be in the midbar for 40 years? Hey, nama shayl dechet amaraglim nigzra aleim shalei konsul aretz arbayim shana. Yeim lashana, yeim lashana. Even though tak pashtus, why were they in the midbar for 40 years? It was ha'inash. That they had a connected every single day of the 40 days. Whatever the pshat is, it's not now time to get into the pshat. What does it mean? Yeim lashana, yeim lashana. What was exactly the chait of Arbaim Yeim? Akapadam Azeh state in Pasuk that Keneged Yeim, every single Yeim of the Arbaim Yeim, whatever those Arbaim Yeim is, they had to stay an extra year in the Midbar. So Kubdachay is that Bapashtas, this that they were in the Midbar for Arbaim Shana, was an inner of an Einish, Keneged Arbaim Yeim that are connected to Chait HaMeragl. So nevertheless, we still have to understand why they were in the Midbar for Arba'im Shana. Because Erei Agzeira, Ois Rak Menegele, Knisasim Laretz Yisrael. Chot B'zeh Shalirotz Lalis Laretz Yisrael, V'loch Nenshu Shalei Konsulei La, Mida Kenegid Mida. Pashtas, what was the chait? The chait is, the chait Amiraglim, that the Yidin didn't want to go to Eretz Yisrael. The klal Mida Kenegid Mida. Is the Eibush said, the Bussin Shgein Arayin Eretz Yisrael, I'm not going to let you take a go to Eretz Yisrael for 40 years. So the English is not going into Eretz Yisrael. אבל הרי חילן ליז ממשן אלו במקום ישוב שלי בארץ ישראל ולי במדבר ובפרט במדבר הגודל והנירה נוח השסור והאקטו וצימן השעים שם אין מויים אז the hate is not to be in ארץ ישראל so they could have been in a different place for 40 years not in a midbar דווקא במקום ישוב in a normal place it's not סתם a midbar they were in that's a gefel lecha midbar a place where there's נחושים and שרפים etc terrible creatures there's nothing to drink etc. Before we go weiter, just one other. In the Kutetera and Parsha Masay, also explains this Indian. He says that there's a reason why the Yidin had to be in the Midbar for Abayim Shana. And he also says, L'chure, they were there for an Einish. So how he's saying, with Darshaning, against the reason why they had to be there for 40 years. He says, in the Kutetera, that the Eibishter is Mesavis HaSibis. He's Mesavis HaSibis. He says that even in Inyan, which happens as an Einish, was dicha b'kavona t'chila. Nothing happens without the kavona elyena. And even though chura is p'chira, and only because a person b'p'chirasi did an aveda, that's why we had this Einish, but we must say that on a certain level, Eibush has set things up in such a way that we should come to such a mass that there has to be an Einish. Now is not the time to get into such a sugya. What this means, avada and avada, the yida is a p'chira, and every single aveda is done b'p'chira chavshis. But nevertheless, Neda little bnei adam, like it brings the chassidus. Every single inyan, there was a kavana tchila. The world was set up l'chatchila in such a way that it would happen. There would be a yirida, and later there would be an einash, etc. So in meila, we could still darshan and explain what's taka, the reason why they had to be there for 40 years. Because there has to be a reason. Is that it was set up like that l'chatchila. Muzm zogan, there's a psati alison. That's what it says in Lukut Teir. Is the Rebbe over here? Is meisav on that? So is the Rebbe saying that even in pshat advarim we have to say that there's a reason why they were there for 40 years? So even without going into the umek, that everything bepeil b'pnimi sein yalim was kavana tchila. Even without the gufa inyim minayu bay is muchrach that there's a teichin and inyim of being b'midbar davke because al tzeinish that could have been b'makim yishuv. The Rebbe is meisav more that were muchrach more taka to say that there's a inyim to get a reason why they were there v'abayim shan. Okay. So what's taka the pshat? Says the Yidden had members masois, 42 masois. It says that 42 words in Anu Becheach. It's a shame of the Eibush, the Shem Mab, which is the 42 words of Anu Becheach. And the Inyan of this name of Shem Mab is the Inyan of Birur Achitzein, Birur of Klippus. That's why, Agav, we say on the Becheach before the Chodedi on Shabbos, because Shabbos is Aliyah Se'ilumis, Eilumis and Isala. This is Aliyah, the Inyan of Birra, Klippus, Birra, Ra, and Aliyah. So before that, we say the Inyan of on the Becheach. So a component that would mem beis masois was that there should be a Achnos Achitzein. How does this play out in the fact that they were had mem beis masois in the Midbar? Because the midbar, the whole Indian of Yinikas Achitzeinim, is a Sheirish Yinikasim of Bamidbar Davke. So he says that, just like Baruch and Kedusha, it says the Beis HaMikdash is the mocker of all Ashbois of Kedusha in the whole world. It's the same thing, when I get to Lumazah, the mocker of Ashbois of all Ashbois of Chitzeinim, of all Inyanim of Yinikas Achitzeinim is in the midbar. Midbar is like the Beis HaMikdash of Klippel Havdu. What's the Pshat? Where do we see that? First of all, in the midbar, especially in that midbar where the Yidden were, it was like we just mentioned previously, was Nachash Saraf and Akrav. It says Nachash Saraf and Akrav is Kinaget Gimel Klippus Atmeis. It's three of them. Nach three negative in Yanimir. Nachash Saraf and Akrav. That's Kinaget Gimel Klippus, Shalosh Klippus Atmeis. It's in Zach. But more in Avonis and Yanim, it says like this. What's the Indian of a midbar? A midbar is a place where there's no tzmicha. Nothing grows. Tzmicha means that it's chais. Chayis is shaykh to Kedusha dafke. Because chayis means that there's nesina. That is ashpo. When a person, Kedusha, the whole union of Kedusha is bitl. Alter Rebbe says in Tanya in Perek Vav. The whole union of Kedusha is that you don't feel yourself, you feel the Eibushtan. A person who's bitl doesn't feel that anything belongs to him. Ad Rebbe, he feels like nothing belongs to him. And Meila is always in a tunu of ashpo. So, a tzmicha, which is shaykh ta shpo, is shaykh ta sada kedusha. Mashenke klippe, which is all in of klippe is yeshes, is in a place of klippe, there's no tzmicha. There's fakert. Yesh wants everything for himself. He's not mashpia. He doesn't give to others. So the midbar, a befrat a midbar, which had nochash sar v'akrov, is the mokir of the place of yinikas hachatzenim of the whole world. So memele, the yidin, had to go into the midbar mem beis masois. Like we said, mem beis is the shame of the Eibushu, which is mevarech hitzenim. They had to go with the Mishkan 42 places in the midbar to machnia the place which is makir of all hashpois of chitzenim. All the Indian of yinikas hachatzenim. Say the mizu. Aidei shechnu es hachatzenim v'achay ishcha maastro imamshichim gil alakus. V'chdei lefuzo utzirchu liiz b'midbar mem shana. The Rebbe adds that it's not only that they were machnia the chitzenim. The emes is they were pale also gila lakusta. Sista zeya, just to be mazu a little bit more. Pashtus, when you learn the maimel lakutitera, it doesn't say like what it says here in the sikha. The Rebbe is medayik from a loshon lakutitera like what it says here. Sista zeya. Pashtus lakutitera, it says that in the midbar they went only to machnia the chitzen. Skafia. To make that the chitzenim shouldn't have any more kayach, shouldn't be able to stand strong, etc. But not that it should be a place which it should be made a lakus. Just that the chitzenim akabonim should already not have such a koyach. Iskafya not isapcha. Elomai, loosid love, there'll be isapcha. Loosid love, there'll be gilal kos mamish. As achon for the union of loosid love, the first love is you have to machnia the klippas. And later, loosid love, because there was already achmas, a klippas is able to be gilal kos in midbarechet. It does say in Lukut HaTeira that the union of Mishkan is gilal kos, like we understand by Pashtus, the mokam ha-Mishkan is mokam ha-Shechina. But not that they were mamshech lakus in the midbar. The says the pashtus, this that the mishkan was the union of gila lakus, is only that they should be ma'at eir dechar b'cheshe. Not that they took the mishkan and mem beis masois in the midbar in order to be mamshech lakus in the midbar. It was only that there should be an union of gila lakus when there's gila lakus ma'at eir dechar b'cheshe. But the midbar itself didn't become a place where there was hamshach lakus in the midbar. That's the pashtus. That knows the pashtus is only going to be lost in love with that to know. But the Rebbe's medayik from the beard of the maimon later, the maimon the has a beard. The lashon of a deer that after he says that the mishkan was machnia the chitzenim of the midbar and lost in love with will be mamish gila lakus is there's a lashon of a deer that v'hoyu mamshichim gila lakus idea mishkan a lashon that says v'hoyu mamshichim gila lakus. The Rebbe's medayik for the lashon. As that the emes is the midbar at Uvgitan, the midbar achieved also an inyan of Gilal Kus inside the Mishkan achieved also an inyan of Gilal Kus in the midbar. It wasn't just that the Mishkan was at Geshein Telakus and through that was Ma'atev Dechar Becheshech. The Mishkan at Geshein Telakus was actually Mamshech Lakus in the midbar. Avad and Avad, the Shleimus of the Sinyan will only be Lohasidlav. But the Aschole of the inyan of Amshach as a Lakus happened also now when the Yidden were in the midbar. It says not only the Aschole, it's Achshore. That there has to be achnos achitzenim in order that later when Mashiach comes there could be amshach zelukus b'midbar. There was even a scholar of the inyan of amshach zelukus gufa when the mishkan was in the midbar. Okay, let's see ha'ara number 8. Rabbi asks Hashanah, if we say then why was there membeis masois in the midbar with the mishkan in order to be machnia the chitzenim and to be mamshach lakus, which is a very vichtik inyan, because the whole tachlis of everything is to make a dirib tachtenim, to take place, which is molly klippus, and to mehapach at the kedusha. So lechure, now the shayla becomes leidach kisa. It was lechatchil the Rebbe asked, if you learn that the whole inyan that they were in the midbar for 40 years was only a inish, so it's not understood why they had to be by midbar dafke. They could have been b'mokim yishuv also. But now that we explain that it was an inyan achreich that they should be by midbar, because otherwise there wouldn't be the inyan of achnos achitzenim and amshach zelukus by midbar. Now it's not understood how does it work with pashtus inyan. A bipshuta shel mikra, they were only in the midbar for 40 years because they had chet ha-meraglim, and ein mikra yetsa b'pshuta. Kum techeis that if they would have not been the inyan of chet ha-meraglim, they would have not been the inyan of going in the midbar for aboyim shon. Is vet shver if being in the midbar for Boim Shon is such an important inyan, it's negit, the kavan of dirba tachteinim. How is that? How can we say that such an inyan was totally on them doing chas v'sham na'aveira? What would have been without the aveira? They wouldn't have had the tachas ha'kavan. So that's what the Rebbe says in the Ora, hey, to mashi lule chet ha'meraglim lo yo yitzrichim liiz v'midbar mem shon. Yesh leimar, lefi sh'oz hoya birir beifan achar. אני מציין ועל דרך המבוא בתראה, בנגיע לחייטי צדס. תסיס לזה. חייטי צדס, it says over there in תראה, after חייטי צדס, what happened to all the magician? He was cursed that he has to be Avedis Adam. He has to start plowing the world, the ground. And till then, he didn't have this Aveda of having to Zeis HaPecha Teicha Lechem. He didn't have to work hard to work with the Adama to be able to produce something, to produce Lechem. After Chayti Tzadas, he says he has to work with the group. What does that mean in Ruch Nisan Yon? He says that the Inyan of Chirisha, Zri, etc. is Avedis HaPirur. Mevar Tev Merah. Just like in Pashto Sain Yonim. You have to take the good part of the land and then you have to Mevar the good part of the Tvua, etc. until you have Lechem. Is that shows that in Ruch Nisan Yonim, the whole Inyan is to Mevar the Tev Merah, to take out the Netzutus of Kedusha from the Ra. Fragt sich the Shaila, Ey Bazei, what would have been without Chayti Tzadas? If the whole union that they had to have, that Mother Magician was given this curse that he has to be chayrish, that he has to work hard with the ground, was only because of Einish, for Chayti Tzadas. L'chura, the union of Avedis HaBirurim is a union which is Negea Ba'atza. If there's Birurim, if there's Nitzetis of Kedusha, which are hidden in Ra, we have to Mevara those Nitzetis of Kedusha. So what would have been without Chayti Tzadas, and if he wouldn't have been cursed to be Tabezeis HaPecha Teichalachim? Says the Alter Rebbe, Avadu Navadu, that we always would have had this union of Birur and Nitzetis. But it would have been able to be done by Eifen Acher. It would have been able to be done just by being Mamshech HaLakus, without getting involved in the Gashmis, just standing from afar and being Mamshech HaLakus. And that itself, the Mamshech HaLakus would be Machnia Uldura, and the Netzitz of Kedusha would be Nigal, would come out, would be Nizbar. There wouldn't have had to be the Inyan of having to go in the Ra and working with the Ra and being Mezachach the Ra until you're able to be Megal the Nitzis HaLakus. You would be able to just stand from far, be Mamshech HaLakus, and that itself would be Machnia the Ra and the Tev would be Nizgal. Says the Rebbe, Al Derech Zeh, we could say here. Al Derech HaMavur B'Teireh. It's not exactly the same Inyan, but Al Derech Zeh, we could say over here. It doesn't touch up exactly what it means over here. What would be the Chiluk of the Birur, of the Midbar, without Chayta Meraglim, and what it is now that there is Chayta Meraglim. But L'chura, we can explain it a little bit more based on what it says in other places in Chassidus. Other Mamorim, Befrat, the Pada B'Shalom Mamorim, there's Mazb that brings, Chassidus B'Chlal, the Rebbe brings in us a lot of Mamorim. There's a difference in the Eifen of the Birur of Chitzenim that was in the Midbar to the Birur of Shleim HaMelech. So it says like about Shleim HaMelech that he sat in Yerushalayim. Amalka Shvo, which was Amalka, Shaykh to Lumaza, came to Shleim HaMelech himself. She came and she was Machniah herself to Shleim. The saying is that Shleim didn't need to go to her place to be Mevarer her. By Shleim being in Yerushalayim, that itself was enough of a Gilui Eir that it attracted, so to speak, the Inyanim that have to be Nizbar. Mashainki ba Midbar. Vahib bin Seo Arin. The Arin went from place to place. It was Taka Machniah, all the Chitzenim and Aif and Av, Mevat the Eir, Dech Haib Rechesh, like we mentioned before. But you had to go to the mokim of the chitzein. It couldn't, it had to be masois. It couldn't be that the Aron should be in one place. And b'derech memeilo, all the inyan of that to be nizbar would be nizbar. The Aron had to go, the mishka, the Aron had to go to the place of the klipah itself. Is l'chura, that's the word over here also. That without chayta meraglim, they wouldn't have been 40 years in the midbar. Says api pshuta shodvan, the taka wouldn't be 40 years in the midbar. But avadu navadu, there would still be the inyan of birur midbar. Elamai would be an Eif L'chura Epis Al Derech like B'Shleim HaMelech. That the Mishkan would stay in one place and all the Netzetzes of Kedusha, all the Inyanim that have to be Nizbar would be Nizbar B'Derech Memel. This Inyan that you have to go to the Mokim Achitzenim Gufa, that was Atatzitzah from Chayta Merak. But Akoponim, thus is clear that the once there was Chayta Meraglim, the fact that they had to be in the Midbar Dafke was not just Altsanainish, it was, like it says in the Pnim of the Sicha, to be able to be Mevarer the Midbar. Okay. The Rebbe continues. The Pashtus, the says to Zeh. The Rebbe is going to say that it's not only in Ruch Nisan Yonim that we're saying that the Mishkan traveling in the Midbar was an Inyan to be Mehapich the Midbar to Amakim of Kedusha, but it was also in Pshat HaDvarim we see that when the Yidden were in the Midbar, they had side the Inyan of Achnoes HaChitzenim and side the Inyan of Hafichas HaMidbar to HaMakim of Kedusha. This is the Pshut HaShul Dvarim. When the Yidden were in the Midbar, the Nochash Sar of Akrav was killed and they Pshut HaShul Dvarim, they changed the Midbar from HaMakim Midbar to HaMakim Yishuv. So Mamela, if we see that that's how it is in Pshut HaShul Dvarim, it fits even more with what we just said, that point of them being in the midbar. For Boim Shannon was to say to Machnir the Chitzenim, like the Harigas Nachas Saravakra, and say to be Mahapich the midbar Tamakim of Kedusha. Mahapich the midbar Tamakim of Yisha. So we didn't say, but Pashtas. Idei Masois Gnei Yisrael, but midbar Hoya Ha'onon. Heirig is an Chashim Akrav. It says that Anan Yaakovid was killed all the Nechashim Akravim. So that's first the first thing that we see that even in Pshuta Shodvarim, the Klippus were Nichna, the Gimel Klippus Atiyas Nachshlar Va'akrav, you killed them through them going in the Midbar. V'gam Havcho is a Midbar and Makam Yishuv. Another Indian is that we see that they changed the Midbar to Makam Yishuv. And like we just said before, the whole Indian of Midbar being a place of Klippus connected to the fact that it's a Midbar Dafka, a place where there's no Tzmicha. They changed it into a place where there's, first of all, it's Bechlal, not the Gedra of a Midbar, like the Rebbe is going to say, and it was Mamash, a place that there was Tzmicha also. Midbar Nivdol Malka Mishu Beikah B'Shnei Inyan, L'Yashav Adam Sham, K'shohayu B'Shishim Rib Bnei Yisrael, Yashav Adam Sham. First of all, Midbar is not a place of Kedusha, Midbar is not a place of a Yishu, because people don't sit up, don't dwell over there. It's when the Shishim Rib of Yisrael, it was a Malka Mishu, there were people there. Ruchnis and Yanim also, this also shows on the Haficha of the Midbar from a Makim of Klippa to a Makim of Kedusha. It says Achsidis, and I bring it also later in the Sicha, Ashel Yashav Adam Sham means Adam Eli, the Eibishter, which is referred to as Adam Eli. But the Midbar is a place where Lakut doesn't reside. Is the fact that in Gashmi it became a place which is Yashav Adam Sham, shows that also in Ruchnis it became a place which is Yashav Adam Eli and Sham. And then the Rebbe says in Beis, that Eretz Lezeruah, like we mentioned before, that a midbar is a place where it doesn't grow, nothing grows over there, and also ruchnis onyan that shows that it's a place of klipa because there's no ashpa, there's no onion of nesina. Is a b'yez v'nei israel b'midbar hoya amayim meberish amiryam megadle minei tshoyim v'yulanis lein tseif. It says in the medrash that when they were in the midbar, there was pashta nes, that the berish amiryam caused that there should be pashta, there should be onion of tzmicha, there should be grass and ilanis, etc., and then trees, etc. So it became eis makim shal eis midbar and a makim of yishuv in pashta senyane. And the Melech, the Ruchnisanyanim, it was not just that they were Machnia, the Klippus, that they killed the Nachashlach of Akrov, but the Pasha became a place, Asher Yashav Adam Elyon Sham, and a place with the Zenyan of Tzmicha, Enyan of Ashpa, Enyan of Nesina, because it was Shaykh to Kedusha with his Bittul, and the Melech, the Zenyan of Nesina. Zel Gamatam, Pnimisanyanim, Shinimno Alvim, Bemiyuchod, Menshleshim Game, Lavidos, and the Nesis, Amishkan Bekela. Shall Yodum Havchas Amidbar as Neshavas Kanal Mulkotate. In the Parsha in Bamidbar, we find that the Levim were counted twice. And besides the fact that they were killed, they were counted separate from the rest of the Yidden. They weren't counted together with all the Yidden. But first, when they were counted separate, they were count, every single Levim ben Chedesh Vamayla was counted. A Levi which was 1 month old was counted. Then the Eibush to say, we have to make a special count, besides for the Minyan ben Chedesh Vamayla, from ben Shleshim Vamayla, Dafke for the Levim which are 30 years old and Vaiter. Why? In connection to those Levim which work in the Mishkan, and even more specifically, like it says in the Torah in these Parshiyos, the Aved of carrying the Mishkan. And the Torah goes on and says exactly which part of Levi carried which part of the Mishkan, which we'll explain later in the Sikha. So we see that besides for the Etzem Minyan of the Levim being counted, they were counted specifically by Eifem Meyuchad, Legabe, the Aved of Nesiyas HaMishkan. They had to be counted, those Levim which are Shaykh to Nesiyas HaMishkan had to be counted by Eifem, a separate counting. What's the pshat? The inyan of Nesiyas HaMishkan is like we just said, carrying the Mishkan in every single place in the Midbar, achieved the inyan of Achnos HaKlippus and Hamshachas Kedusha in the Mishkan. So he used that the Levim who were carrying the Mishkan were being Isaac in this special Aved of Achnos HaKlippus and Hamshachas Kedusha in the Mishkan, in the Midbar. So they needed a minyan specifically legabi this inyan. That says it's not enough that they had a minyan bechlal, they had to have the inyan of minyan in connection bedafke to the inyan of carrying the mishkan. Kya yidea minyan amiyuchad binyan zel nasa v'miyuchad bezel davar chashuv. V'lochen amidbar layifal aleim, ki davash v'minyan leibatl, v'adra b'myaf chesu laris nishavs. It says, it says in Shaloh, that brings in many sichas, that why b'chlau were yidin counted? Because there's a klau in halacha, that davash v'minyan ain't a bottle. Something which is counted, like eggs, which you count every single one individually, has a special chashivas, and it doesn't become bottle, like for example, if it falls into a Isser, if it's one of them is not kosher and it falls into a heter, it doesn't become bottle if it's davar shebeminyan. So for the same reason Yidden were counted, because through that Yidden became very chashev, became such a chashev zecher davar shebeminyan lay bottle. But fact that a yid's a davar chashu, fact, a yid's a davar chashu. That itself, that chashivas that a yid has, also, being a yid, that he got the special chashivas, that he was counted and given a special chashivas as a yid, is not enough when it comes to the aveda of being machniach itseinim, and especially to be mahapach them to kedusha. This is such a hard aveda, like especially like we'll see soon in the sicha when he talks in aveda sa'od. But this is such a hard and special aveda that it's not enough that you're a davar chashu b'chla. You have to be considered chashuv legabi this inyan b'miyuchad, and that the gabi this inyan b'miyuchad you shouldn't be bafel. Because feeling pashtus on you when you're being isik in a fight in a lumaze, you have a fight. It's not just that you're being doing avedis Hashem. There's a fight here. There's a stark lumaze. You have to machnia the lumaze and fakerpi ma'apchet kedusha. Is azasar zach is you could lose the battle. It's one thing if you have stam aveda, but when there's a stark menagid, you could lose the battle chas v'shal. So there has to be an inyan of minyan which gives you chshivas that you shouldn't be bottled and fakert. You should be misgaber on the cheshach and not the cheshach as v'shalom on you. So mainly Levim, which carried the Mishkan, had to be counted not just in the regular count of Ben Chedesh and Ma'il, that have a special inyan of minyan b'miyuchad legabi this inyan of Nesis HaMishkan. Bez Hashem, v'imam shech the rest of the sikh in the next year.